coming to the camera.
What's up, guys? Beme here from the relationshipnotcool.com. And today, what I want to talk about is what to do when you feel like you're in the friend zone. Maybe you are, maybe you're not. So, recently, I had a question come to me about, from a friend of mine, that basically talked about he's going through something. So he's been friends with this girl, and he's been friends with this girl for a while, and the other day he actually told her that he didn't have feelings for her. Now, the problem is this girl has a boyfriend already. So the boyfriend and her long distance relationship, so he's not around as often. And he thinks this can be an opportunity for him because he doesn't think they might be together for a long time. So this is a different situation on what I'm going to talk about. So this situation is kind of what majority of people go through, right? A lot of guys especially go through. It's rare when you see a girl that's like, oh, he's just friend zoning me. He doesn't like me or whatever the case is. Because us men, we think we're our cops. Unfortunately. But some men that have like a strong friend, you know, maybe if he has a girlfriend and they befriend the girl that his friend likes him, then that's different. That's different. But in terms, we're just gonna talk about a guy being friend zoned. Now, when you do get friend zoned, sometimes I believe that when you meet a friend of a person of the opposite sex, so if it's a girl meeting a guy or a guy meeting a girl, in the beginning, it's usually 95% of the time never starts as a friendship. It's like a little attraction there. Now, if you don't do the right things, and I'm talking from a guy's perspective, you do the right thing where you make it known in the beginning. Like Mark Manson says in the book Model, you have to kind of joke around a little bit and put a little bit of sexuality in your conversations. Like make even little jokes on the way you touch her. If you're joking about something, you touch her a specific way. Whatever the case is, just like you're showing your intent through your physical touch. And that will make you more attractive. This is how you kind of, it's an easy, and I don't know why guys make this so complex, easy way to get out of the friend zone. But later, if you notice you've gone into the friend zone, you're getting too deep in there, and you just blurt out, I like you, it's not gonna work. In that situation, for it to work, you literally will have to stay friends with it. You're playing the long game here. It's not gonna happen overnight, especially if she has a boyfriend. What you will have to do is basically be patient, be around her, listen to her problems. Yes, you're being the nice guy, the white knight, as they say. But in that, just show that you care for her, but not too much. You wanna go on and off. So it's like, yes, you'll be there for her, but you know, there's times when you're busy, you're doing your own thing, you're taking care of shit in your own life. Not only that, but if you feel like you're deep in the friend zone, just start dating other girls. There's no other easier way than to start dating other girls. You're looking to get with this girl, but it's just not gonna happen. You just focus solely on her. Let her see how you are with other girls. Let her meet the other girls. What happens in that situation is she'll see what an awesome douche, and she'll be like, holy shit, I'm missing out on this. And she'll kind of start like rationalizing why you're probably the better pick. And when you hang out, you start noticing her flirting with you a little more often than she used to. Even if she has a boyfriend, some of the times. But you're playing the long game. This can go for months, even years. You just have to understand. If you really want this girl, you would wait. But usually, most of the time, you meet someone else that's probably a little more awesome, unfortunately, and you kind of lose attraction to that girl for a little while. But it might just happen that you guys, you know, after you go through with their girl, she's around, it's kind of like you don't want her to be a rebound. But who knows? Like maybe that rebound will turn into something greater. But usually, rebounds don't work. So you want to do something the right way. You want to do this the right way. So if you just get out of a relationship and just go straight to her and say, like, oh, we can be together now. I know this is like, you can't hide it anymore, whatever the case is. Just let it happen over time. Let it happen organically. Force it. See, when you force things, it doesn't work out well. And I know this from personal experience. You force a relationship, not like forcefully verbal, you make it more like this. I want you more to be sexually aggressive, be very aggressive. It's like, you won't. In that case, it won't last long. And you get, and you lose a friendship. What if you're really love the friendship, and you love it? Like her at the same time. You don't want to lose the friendship, so you don't want to fuck up. So just know what option there is. There's a time when you're like, maybe this girl's just going to be a friend. I have friends like that where it's like, this girl's just going to be a friend. Even if we met at the wrong time. It was just the wrong place at the wrong time. You guys know. That's all. And I don't know if you believe that. I think that's true. It's always the wrong time and place to meet a person. Sometimes you just have to come back later, a few years later, things change. And I feel like that's your best way to solve it. In this case, play the long game. You have to be patient. I will talk more about this topic because it's a really broad topic. That's just a few little things to help you out if you are stuck in something as you. So, I'm going to end it here because I got to take a major piss. So, you guys stay awesome. Enjoy.